Back in 2005, the plush toy company Gantz created one of the earliest toys to life concepts called webkinz. You'd go to a store, buy a webkinz plush, and it would have a little tag attached to it, which contained a secret code. With this secret code, you could go on webkinz.com, make an account, and redeem that exact animal into the web game. It was an MMO made for kids. You could play games, earn prizes, collect clothing and furniture, and unsurprisingly, it very quickly gained a cult following. As a kid, I was primarily focused on the video game part of it, but as an extension, it made me interested in plushes. The web game did such a good job of attaching personality and character to these plushes that I owned. They were like my friends. And before I knew it, I was obsessed. Between my brother and I, we had like 30 webkinz plushes, all from different birthday and Christmas gifts. And little 8-year-old me wanted so many of them because I wanted to make YouTube videos about them.
I hope you enjoyed those videos. And now here is a word from our sponsor.
Hey, I'm Tigger. Lately, Zingos have been disappearing. Is that right, Mr. Zingo?
Using my mom's digital camera, I created a library of YouTube videos starring my webkinz plushes. I used to write comedy skits, I would do shows with multiple episodes, and even do like basic editing. And sadly, I can't show you any of these videos because they've been lost to time. The account was terminated because I was under the age of 13. I owe webkinz a lot for giving me the inspiration to start making videos on YouTube all that time ago.
Oh, what's the coolest thing about webkinz? What's the coolest thing about webkinz?
The coolest thing is everything!
Every time I look back at what webkinz really was, it's easy to understand why I liked it so much. I've always been fascinated by anything electronic, anything with a screen, and associating the plushes with the video game was a really clever way to get kids like me interested in a thing I definitely wouldn't have wanted otherwise. With that being said, webkinz has been off my radar for the past decade. It was trendy for a while in the mid-2000s, but it faded away, as all trends do. I was fully expecting webkinz to have closed up shop and moved on in a similar way that Club Penguin did, but no. Webkinz is still alive and well. The original 2005 webkinz is still around, but with a few new coats of paint. It used to run in Flash, now it runs in Adobe Air. It has its own desktop client powered by Electron, the same framework that Discord uses. And Adobe Air and Electron are cross-platform, so they were able to port it to iOS and Android, and I think that was a great idea for longevity. But why are they putting all this effort in for a 15-year-old game? Well, because it's still profitable. They're actually making more profit now than they were a few years ago, because in 2019, they stopped producing plushes altogether and replaced it with the Gantz eStore, where you can just buy the virtual pets and in-game items directly, and I'm fine with that. It's a free MMO, they gotta keep the lights on. I'm genuinely impressed at how much maintenance this game still gets after all this time. It's still a full-time job for people. And just from looking at these blog posts, you can tell that this crew still really, really cares about the game. But it's not just the blog posts. The webkinz crew have a podcast called the Podkinz. And I feel like that's kind of a missed opportunity. They could have called it the Kinzcast, and that sounds a lot better. I tried to listen to it, but it's kind of hard to get through because it's basically just advertising new webkinz stuff for 45 minutes. But I did try. So the webkinz team is still actively updating it. It still has a reasonably large player base, enough to keep the company afloat. You can play it on a range of different modern devices. The membership fees aren't too expensive, and all the other fees are optional. And looking at all that, yeah, that looks pretty good. But none of it matters if it doesn't answer the golden question. Is the game fun? I put almost 6 hours into the game during the course of working on this video. And yeah, it is fun. Even by today's standards, webkinz holds up. The game is better now than it was when I was a kid because they've added an absolute boatload of stuff to do. There's so much content in this video game that while I was recording footage, I was getting impatient, trying to see everything that there was to see. And honestly, it is super generous of them that they're willing to let people experience webkinz for free at all. Back in the early days, you had to pay an entrance fee. You didn't have a choice. But why is there so much content? When this game was still new, its success was entirely riding on making the best game they possibly could in order to stand out among Neopets, Club Penguin, RuneScape, Free Realms, Wizard 101, MapleStory, Roblox, Movie Star Planet, EverQuest, Toontown Online, Moshi Monsters. These are all massively multiplayer games made for kids during that time period, and webkinz had to do a lot to stand out because its competitors were free. Kids had to convince their parents to buy a plush to play webkinz. And of course, webkinz went fully free to play in 2013. But the fact that the production of webkinz plushes only just halted in 2019, 14 years years after they initially released is a testament to the staying power of Webkinz. Speaking of the plushes, let's talk about those. Chalk it up to nostalgia if you want, but I definitely have a soft spot for Webkinz character designs. Most of the original plushes were just based on real animals. My first Webkinz plush was the spotted frog, because I love frogs. And a few years in, they started getting crazy with the designs, and I totally dig it. So I'm gonna show you some of my favorites. This one's the Lilkins Husky, and they are so small. This is the lilac guinea pig, such a chonker. I love the orca. I love him, he's so stupid. I wanna swing him around like a bat. He's so cute. I love the Daisy pig. She looks so sleepy. They do this really funny thing with the birds where they just make them sit, and they look so polite. Like, look at the, look at the toucan. No thoughts. Head empty. But not all of them are good. Some of them... Ooh, that doesn't look very good. Oh. No, I don't like that one. Okay. Like, some of these are so gaudy that I unironically love them. Like, look at this iguana. I love them. This unicorn is just so abrasive in their design. I love it.
Look at this giraffe. Oh my god, they even gave them little eyelashes. Ah, they're too powerful.
And this is the zigzag zebra. Do I even need to explain why I love this? And then there's the rainbow zebra. Wait, isn't this the fruit stripe gum zebra?
It totally is, it's the fruit stripe gum zebra.
His name is Yipes, apparently, I didn't know that. They also had this promo where they did like rock and roll themed pets called Webkinz Rockers. There were a whole bunch of them, but here are my favorites. The Rockers Cat, the Rockers Fox, and the Rockers Papillon. They're kind of cool looking, I like them. One of the very extensive themes that they do is they have like a whole bunch of different patterned puppies, and I love them. This is the tie-dyed puppy, an absolute babe. This is the jelly bean puppy, and they were literally so precious that I had to buy one of my own. I don't even need to introduce the polka dot puppy, just look at them. You've also got the food-themed ones, which are really good. Cupcake pup, chocolate pup, lollipop pup, donut pup, ice cream pup, cherry soda pup, gingerbread pup. So for the Christmas-themed ones, you've got the snowflake pup and the peppermint pup, and then you've got the spooky pup and the zombie pup.
You got the patchy pup, the pizzazzy pup, the harmony pup, the cheer pup, the peace puppy, the tropical island pup, the scribbles pup, the love puppy. This puppy loves you.
The texting pup, no. No, really? The texting puppy is a Webkinz pet that was released in August 2123. That's a long time from now. Its pet specific food is the lol biscuits.
OMG, it's the texting puppy. You'll be raffle when you add this funny friend to your Webkinz family of pets,
and they'll always BRB when you serve up some lol biscuits for them to munch on. Your texting puppy will think these lol biscuits are totally OMG. Well, time to delete my Webkinz account. I'm gonna give a bunch more weirdos and then we'll move on. The color block monkey, the aloha dolphin, the apatosaurus,
the nightmare,
the lucky dino.
This one's literally just Floppa. And this one's just like a photorealistic beaver. Yes, this is real. This is a real Webkinz. Webkinz products weren't entirely limited to plushes. There were all kinds of accessories as well, such as little clothing you could put on them. They had purses for you to put the plushes in. There were figurines and little charms. They even had things like body spritz, which was like kids' perfume that you're supposed to spray on the pets to make them smell like banana. And that's disgusting. Webkinz even had an entire trading card game. And I bought an entire box of them, and later in this video we're gonna open it up and see what's inside, so stick around for that. Anyway, now that we've talked about the products, let's talk about the game itself and what there is to do in it. First up, the arcade. There are 71 individual games in the arcade, 45 of which you can play without a deluxe membership. It's very easy to tell which games are old and which games are new because they're aesthetically completely different. Grand Grotto was clearly designed for the Webkinz mobile game, and they backported it to Webkinz Classic. It's just another stupid collapse-like mobile game where you match gems, very groundbreaking stuff. Goody Gumdrops is clearly another newer one, likely made for the mobile game as well. It's an endless runner where you eat candy. It's passable. Dogbeard's Gold feels like an ad that you'd see while playing a different mobile game. Hatch the Dragon. Dude, it's a 2048 clone. Are you serious? Hoppy Little Rocket Ship. It's a Doodle Jump clone. Bruh. All of the good games in the arcade are just direct clones of games that already exist.
Cash Cow is a one-to-one clone of Collapse. Zingo's Bouncin' Burst is a one-to-one
one-to-one clone of Buster Brothers. Candy Bash is a breakout clone and Candy falls out of the blocks, and I think it's kind of fun. Eager Beaver Adventure Park is literally exactly Bookworm. Whimsy Skies is Mr. Doe. Hungry Hog is Pac-Man. Zingo's Pop is Bust-A-Move. Zacky's Quest is Frogger! You can't patent game design concepts, so it's not like they're doing anything wrong here. By copying games that are already well-liked, you get to have a lot more of them because a lot of video games already exist. And the interesting part is that I found myself playing Eager Beaver Adventure Park a lot more than Bookworm, because Bookworm doesn't give me kinz cash for playing it. It's kind of an interesting metagame, because the better you do, the more kinz cash you get. Aside from the arcade, there's still a ton of stuff to do. Generally, my day-by-day would look something like this. Head over to the curio shop to see if I can get his gym of the day, and I never do. Then I'll go to the employment office and do a job. Have my daily goes at the Wheel of WoW and the Wishing Well. Then I'll take a look at both clothing outlets to see if they have anything on special. Go to the Kinsville Academy and brush up on my skills. Go to the Magical Forest, catch some fairies. Then I'll do Alyssa's Star Challenge. Play some pachinko, snap some photos of some zums, and then take care of the ones I have. Playing online with random people in the tournament arena is really fun, so I like to do that. And all the while, I'll be checking up on my pets, making sure they're all well-fed and well-rested, and then I look down at the clock and an entire hour has passed, and I'll never get that time back. But it's time for us to shift gears a bit, because as with any video game, it ain't perfect. It has plenty of problems of its own. Alright, first off, let's talk about the TVs. I vividly remember watching the Monkey and Monkey Show as a kid. It was like an in-universe, like, stand-up comedy thing, and I wanted to see it again, but I had no idea how much of an adventure this would end up being. If you go to the W shop, there's like a whole section of TVs, and when you click on any of them, it says, this item can be turned on to entertain your pet. And if you look on the Webkinz wiki, it confirms this. To use a TV, simply click on it, and it will bring up your TV remote. Just choose one of the channels listed below, and a screen will pop up playing the show you selected. So I did exactly that. I bought a TV from the W shop, plopped it down in the room, and I clicked on it. And nothing happened. So I bought a different TV, plopped that one down, clicked on it, and nothing happened. No remote, nothing. And so I got to Googling. Turns out this is a bug in the game that was discovered 4 years ago and still hasn't been fixed. The only place that has a functioning TV is if you go to the Kinz Chat Clubhouse and go to the after school room. For some reason, the TV's in there? Yeah, they work exactly as intended. Why? I don't know why. I don't. But mission complete, I guess. I got to take a nostalgia trip with the Monkey and Monkey Show. It's not very good, but what you're seeing right now is me zooming into the window in post, because what I'm looking at looks like this. This tiny, tiny box with no way to do full screen, no way to resize the TV show window, no scaling options whatsoever. And scaling is a consistent problem in this game. Flash is a vector format, which means that it's really good at scaling. Even though Homestar Runner was designed for computer monitors from the 2000s, it's made in Flash, so you can just scale it up and it looks fantastic. But I suppose for authenticity, or maybe it was just easier, they've preserved all of the older assets of Webkinz in their original resolution, which means that some things are just really tiny, and there's a lot of wasted space on the screen. Like, look at this. I gotta move my face closer to the screen to see this. Come on. May I remind you, these games were originally made in Flash. At least give me the option to zoom them in, even at the expense of perhaps some raster assets looking kind of pixelated. I don't care. Oh, and speaking of options, there are none. Not a single settings menu to be found anywhere. I wanted to tweak the audio volume because this game is really, really loud for some reason. It hits the 0 decibel mark with basically every sound effect and sometimes just straight up clips. I know that not having an accessible settings menu is to prevent kids from breaking everything, but God, I would love the option to make the game not full screen. It's always full screen, and as far as I know, there's no way to play it in a window at all. Oh yeah, also, the Kinsville movie theater? Yeah, that just doesn't work at all. If you click on it, a gray box that says please wait opens up and closes a half second later. It's an entire building that serves absolutely no purpose, just to take up space. Another thing, there is no scroll bar in the arcade, so if you want to get to a game that's near the bottom of the list, you gotta start smashing your mouse button like crazy until you get there. And when you get back to that menu from playing a game, it starts all the way at the top again, so you gotta smash your mouse button a million more times to get it back down! This seems like a reasonably minor issue compared to features of the game just not working at all, but it really got on my nerves when I was trying to try out all the games. Okay, so earlier in this video, I gave Webkinz team a ton of appreciation for continuing to add new content to the game, but new content isn't always the solution. You have to build off of what's already there. Like, Webkinz is a bookshelf that's completely full of books, no more shelf space, so they just start
stacking books on the floor in front of the bookcase. Like, yeah, there's more content, but it's sitting on the floor in front of the bookcase.
Even amongst all of these problems, for the entire creative process of making this video, I've still logged on every day, because the game is still consistently entertaining. Focusing on quality of life tweaks doesn't affect their bottom line. The Webkinz team has no motivation to tweak things to make the game slightly better. It's too old to make the effort worth it, and doing so makes no money. But adding new content to the game always brings in sales, like, ooh, that new reindeer pet, it's limited edition for Christmas, you gotta get it now or it's gonna go away forever, bam, you made a sale. You did it. It's difficult for the developers because I imagine that the 2005 codebase they have to work with is held together with hot glue and prayers, and it's more difficult for the hardcore veterans because they have to get used to changes to things that haven't been changed in like 10 years. Let me make a comparison here. Minecraft. The original version was written in Java, it was one of Notch's first serious game development projects, and he was still an amateur. So some of the decisions he made when he was building the framework of that game in 2009 is inevitable that eventually you're gonna encounter some Java spaghetti and meatballs in the codebase. A lot of the time for projects that old, it's easier and less expensive to just duct tape it together than it is to throw out the whole codebase and start over. And when Mojang was acquired by Microsoft, you know what they did? They threw out the whole codebase and started over, and they rewrote the entire game in C++. And sure, the Java version of the game is still maintained, but it's difficult to argue that crossplay, ray tracing, and drag and drop mod support doesn't make the remake of Minecraft better than the original. Microsoft had the funding and the staff to justify rewriting the entire game, and I guarantee you that Gantz does not have that same luxury. Or do they? If you go to webkinz.com, you'll see, whoa, wait a second, what is that? All new game, what? 15 minutes into this video and you finally get to understand what the second half of the title means. Webkinz did a reboot. And also, it like just came out in late October 2020 and they wrote a big long blog post about it. Let's go read it.
Join the family, Webkinz.
Very incredibly creative title. And by the way, it is just called Webkinz. There's no subtitle, it's literally just called Webkinz. Look, watch this. If you have both Webkinz Classic and the new Webkinz installed, you just have Webkinz and Webkinz. Windows is like, do you want to play Webkinz or Webkinz? I don't know which one you want to play. The Webkinz community has been colloquially naming this Webkinz Next, and I think that's actually kind of a cool name, so I'm gonna call it that from now on. Hi, this is Evan popping in for a second while I'm editing. It turns out that Webkinz Next isn't just a community-made colloquial name. If you go to the Gantz World blog all new Webkinz FAQ post, and then view the source code of it, you can scroll down and see that the post was tagged Webkinz Next. It doesn't say Webkinz Next anywhere on their website, but honestly, that's enough confirmation for me that the creator of this post tagged it Webkinz Next. I imagine that must be some sort of an internal name. Anyway, back to the video.
In 2005, Gantz introduced Webkinz and changed the world of toys forever. With a line of lovable plush and an exciting online world that brought the toys to life, Webkinz has been enjoyed by millions of kids and teens and parents.
Kids, teens, and parents? But no adults? What do you mean? I'm an adult! I don't have to have children to enjoy your game.
Now we're gonna do it all over again. Exciting new Webkinz world created from the ground up for a new generation of players and devices with tons of improvements and exciting new features like dog and baby. And you can put pieces of cheese on your cat's head and then you can talk to people. And also the game that you sank all that money into, we're not gonna delete it, don't worry. We love Webkinz Classic as much as you.
Ruh-roh, Raggy, that's a low rating. Also, the release date that's listed on the Microsoft Store page is just literally wrong. It says that it came out like 6 months ago, and it did not. All right, let's see what we got.
Hello. Welcome to the Kinzville Adoption Center.
I cannot stress enough how terrifying the animation of this game is. I was so ready to like it. I played Webkinz religiously when I was little, and I recently got back into it.
You look new here, so let me help you through adopting your first pet. Here are some pets that would love to be part of your family.
Oh my god, is that Garfield? That's literally Garfield. I can't believe they got the rights to him. That's amazing.
Now use these spinners to create a world name. This is the name that others will know you as in Kinzville.
Saltwater sand, baby. That's what I'm talking about. Hello? Is there anybody here? I guess everybody's quarantining for COVID-19. I would like to get a coffee at this cafe, but there's no one here. Hello, is anybody home? Okay. Well, how about this one? Feature coming, okay, I get it. I'm the only cat in the entire world. Oh my God, there's another player. They're an exact clone of me. Type chat allows players to type with their like distinction. Okay, that sounds good to me. And just enable that, and there we go. These two cats are conjoined. These cats are one cat. Yeah, there we go. I am Garfield and you are Odie. I am, and you are. I'm Garfield.
I'm...
You're so fashionable. I can't believe they got the rights to use Garfield's likeness and his name is censored in the chat.
I'm the orange cat from the comics.
All right, enough goofing around. Let's get into what's actually good about the reboot. It's a brand new code base, which means it's very well optimized. I ran the game both at 1080p and 4K, and it performed beautifully, no frame rate issues. And can I just say, wow, this arcade menu is fantastic compared to the original. They have plenty of room for all the games. They can put daily special games at the top without disturbing the rest of the list. Really good stuff here.
The transitioning animation for going in and out of your house is actually really cool. I really like that.
You can enable advanced editing mode, which allows you to place furniture wherever you want in your house without having to worry about it being locked to a grid. And that's really cool.
And that's basically all the good things I have to say about it.
Well, it's time for the bad. Needless to say, the 3D modeling and animation work is extremely uncanny. It's not just me. All the reviews mention this as like a primary talking point. This game looks creepy. Another big problem that I have is that no one plays this game. It's a uniquely unsettling scenario to walk around an MMO with nobody in it. In Webkinz Classic, I feel like I had encounters with other players all the time. Of course, this game is still new. I don't expect it to gain a player base right away, but I wouldn't be surprised if player base retention was a problem for this game. The lack of parity between Webkinz Classic and Webkinz Next creates this huge gap of adoption between the two games. If someone was already interested and invested in Webkinz Classic, why would they bother to play a vastly inferior version of the game they like? Why should they give up a game with literally thousands of pets for a game that has 8 in total? I recognize that 3D modeling and animation requires more skill than creating a 2D puppet in Flash, especially when a lot of them pull from the same base, but they really should have waited on releasing Webkinz Next until it actually would create some competition with its predecessor. Any reasonable Webkinz fan would start up Webkinz Next once, realize that it has nothing in common with Classic, and then go back to their comfort zone. Gantz executives have had to make some really difficult decisions. If they killed off Webkinz Classic and Webkinz Next took its place, the entire player base would be without a home. I'm going to draw a comparison to one of Webkinz's early competitors, Club Penguin. Club Penguin was a 2005 online MMO made in Flash, and it was so successful that it was acquired by Disney in 2007. 10 years later, in 2017, Disney killed off Club Penguin, created a new Club Penguin game that was 3D and modern, and everyone hated it because it was completely different from the game they liked. And then Club Penguin Island closed their doors not even a year later. Gantz is very deliberately refusing to make the same mistakes as Club Penguin, and what they're doing right now is a good alternative. It may be more expensive to develop and maintain two games at the same time, but killing off a massive source of revenue like that is a good way to go bankrupt. I really hope to see Webkinz Next grow into something really special. It has potential, even if right now it's a bit disappointing. But for now, my heart belongs to Classic. So earlier I mentioned that Webkinz stopped production of plushes, and that is true. But very recently, as a promotion for Webkinz Next, they started like a second generation of plushes. Right now there are only two, the Golden Lab and the Unicorn, and I hate both of them. They are so weird looking. The plushes come with a code for both Classic and Next, so you can redeem it on both, and that's pretty cool. Speaking of Webkinz and products, let's open that huge box of trading cards, shall we?
Boom! Webkinz trading cards! It's an entire box of them! 36 packs, I believe it is?
You can win a free Webkinz online!
That's what we want. That right there, that's the goal, boys. That's what we want. But first, before we get started, I gotta put my gloves on. And this is taking forever. Aha! Perfect! Now I won't get my greasy fingers on the cards. It's sealed and I gotta get it open. Come on! Let me in. Come on.
I can't get it open.
There we go. There we go. Now I can slide it off. Yeah, boy. They let you have a peek inside. Oh, look at that. There's some packs in there. I would never have guessed. Too scared to rip it. Let's go. Come on. Yes.
And then what you do is you fold it down like that. And then you insert it like, and you insert like that. And then you have a little store display. See? Isn't that cool?
But we don't care about the store display, we just wanna go pow! Ah, no, I made a mess up. How am I gonna get enough grippiness on my fingers with these gloves to peel this open? Oh, that worked. Wait, did it? No, it didn't, I didn't actually get in. Ah, oh no, I lost a finger. No, get back on there.
I don't know why I'm committing to this bit with the finger gloves, it's so stupid.
All right, what have we got here? We got Mama's Secret Recipe. Oh, this is like a game? I thought it was just trading cards, but these like do stuff. Is there a game to be had here? Food cards? Hey, eats your trash. Your Webkinz is guaranteed to have sweet dreams when dozing upon pillows of fluffy whipped cream. Charmed, I'm sure. What is... Challenge. Hey guys, I'm doing a Webkinz challenge today. Like and subscribe. Whoa, this one's a shiny one. Dog Beard and Captain Patch's treasure. You can even see the reflection of the phone I'm using to record. That one's a shiny. I'll put that one in the shiny pile. And this one is a code, which I am going to censor because I want to see what they do in the game. And that's gonna go in the code pile. Oh, there's a game rules card. You can play a game. Well, I guess I'm gonna have to try that at some point. Okay, I figured out the trick to opening these. It is just like opening a pack of Pokemon cards. Trash. That one's trash. And trash. Trash. And there's a code card. That's going in the code pile. No shinies in that one.
Wait, so does every single pack have a code card? Because I think this one has a code card as well. Yeah, it does. So I think every single pack has a code card in it. That's pretty sick.
It's Mr. Milkman from... what's that game called? Cash Cow,
it's on the card. What am I talking about? It's right there.
It says it on the card.
It's a rare globe. Very rare globe. Need to chill out. Build a snow dog.
Ooh, wow. It's Nefaria. She's so nefarious. That's why her name is Nefaria. I get it.
I've only gotten one shiny so far. What's going on? Where are all my shinies? I guess they'd be called hollows.
And the code card goes in the code card pile. Boop.
Wow, he missed that Zingo. He struck out.
The kids at school are gonna be so jealous that I got 36 packs of Webkinz trading cards.
Dex dangerous. He's very dangerous. Don't mess with him. He's trying to give you a glomp. You know what I'm saying?
Ew, I don't like the idea of sleeping in a candy bed. I feel like it would be sticky.
Ow! Oh my god! Oh, I gotta blur that. Look at him! I got one! I got a free pet! Oh my god, that's so cool!
This is great. I gotta see what that is.
I'm gonna put that in the special code pile. Pet dog. Don't tell me what to do, but I will do that. Goober's grand experiment. He made the cupcake really big.
Oh, that's a cute doggy. I like that love puppy. That's great. Inukshuk.
Inukshuk making me sneeze. And yummy, yummy sakbing rings. Did you know? Webkinz trading cards exist.
It's Wiggles. Plumpy's best friend. Looks like Luke.
Epoch Quark's glimmer.
Okay, why is it in an hourglass?
Ooh, a pirate.
That's not a pirate, that's a treasure chest. Discard two pet cards and one location card. Say, I love my Webkinz. You have to, like, say stuff in this card game? I'm confused. I gotta read the rules at some point. I guess I didn't even show the pack yet, but this is what the pack looks like. Five trading cards, one feature code card per pack.
I just want to open the pack. Just let me open the pack.
All right, fine. Gloves are coming off. All right, the gloves are off. I'm not gonna deal with that bit anymore. All right, no more gloves. This should be easy to open.
Oh, it's so much easier.
Amazing. Oh my god, it's so easy to grip him now. Whoa, funky girl. That is not a girl. That is a half of an egg. Pie eating contest. Whoa, look at this rabbit. He's so cute.
Strawberries.
Those are really beautifully modeled. I feel like those seeds are like way too uniform. It looks weird. Kin's post office. Oh, that's a good cat. I like that cat. I want to squish him. He looks like a pillow. The movie's bad. Yeah, okay. My diner. I've already seen all these cards before. It sucks. Now that I'm this far in, there's nothing new.
Yeah,
Yeah. Okay, yep, nothing new. Yep, Okay, there's Miss Birdie. Get ready for adventure. Alright, cool, nothing. Fluffington, Rock Garden.
I don't think so!
Polar Plunge Trophy, and Arcade Extravaganza. Alright. Wacky Zingos, Wacky Grazdataz. Oh, that looks delicious. I wanna eat that.
Oh, another shiny! It's Art in the Lost Tomb!
And it's weird because this is like a shiny that's like a mirror. Like, I can see my big five head. Look, there's my five head and my glasses. Well, hey, we finally got another shiny after all that time. Put that in the shiny pile that I have two cards in. I'm like Max Mofo, except I only do Webkinz content now. Ooh, what is this?
Oh, I'm sorry I spoiled it, but it's another shiny card. It's Sweets and Treats at paw level. I want to go to the paw level. Yes, boys.
I bet the rest of this is just garbage.
Sure is.
Didn't mean to spoil that for myself, sorry.
Wiggles. Yep, I've seen you. Oh my god, another shiny!
That's three in a row, Jesus, that's crazy.
Chummed, I'm sure.
What does it say on the back? The three explorers triapsed through some low shrubs and emerged next to...
Mom, what does triapsed mean? I don't know!
Look, it's Luke again. Oh, there he is. Circle of Friends, Topiary, Clubhouse, Wizard, Tree Frog.
Oh, another?
Oh, yeah, that is a shiny. Look at the mirror. Look at that. That's like a vanity with an actual, like, mirror in it. That's so cool. Man, we're getting crazy shinies all of a sudden. Okay. Yeah.
Oh, my God! Okay, we want another Webkinz pet. Yes! That's amazing. I always wonder if they're gonna someday, like, deactivate these codes, you know? So, like, I open this up and it's just like, nope, that's not real anymore. Sorry, that pack's too old. That is so dope. I gotta see what I get from that. God, I'm gonna be entering those codes for hours. Ooh! A new cat in town! She's apparently in Dr. Seuss world. What? Are you the Lorax? But there you go, I guess. Another shiny. Hot chocolate, frozen mug, Dex Dangerous, Monkey Girl, goggles, and nothing. All right, what did it say? Oh, it could send a gift. All right, well, that's it. That's all we got. We got 6 holographic cards. That's pretty sick. Look at that.
Yeah, baby. Yeah, look at them shine.
And we got 2 free pets. I imagine this is 36 codes. We got 36 code cards. I'm gonna have to take a look through those, and I'm gonna see what pets I get.
The first pet code that I ended up getting was the spotted frog, which, by the way, if you remember earlier in the video, I mentioned that this exact species was my first childhood Webkinz. My jaw hit the floor, I was so excited. And naturally, I named him Harold, because that's what I named him as a kid. The second pet code ended up being a white terrier. I named her Shoof, obviously. You've definitely seen these two rascals running around in the game footage I showed on screen throughout this video, alongside Listerine, who is my free Webkinz that you get when you create an account. I also redeemed a whole bunch of codes from the code cards, but after I spent an entire hour doing that, it got really tedious, and I just felt like I should give them away. So here you go. This will give you some kinz cash, clothing, furniture, rare food, all kinds of things. Have fun! Oh yeah, also Patreon. If patreon.com/clue reaches 60 patrons, we're gonna take my giant stack of Webkinz trading cards, and Luke and I are gonna sit down and learn how to play the Webkinz trading card game, and we'll make a video about it. It's gonna be supremely epic. Right now we got 54. We're so close. Go to patreon.com/clue. Any tier, 60 patrons, we're gonna do it. Thank you so much for watching. Don't leave yet, because it's time for the Patreon read. Ian Klug, Precious Yuba, Sonic the Marketable Plushie, Colonial Boy Luke, Great Wow, Beyblade, Betty A, Flight66, Super King, Sunfish, Yukinoka, KK Cider, Spark the Pug, Scarlet Rubelite, Rosabelle, Sleep Song, Sweet Aisha, Me, Anthony Minardo, Buddy Boy, Dallas, Selkie, Dan the Man, Reese, Ryan Hodge, Caleb Turek, Zascarf, Invalid, Emma, Lunar X Lights, Alexis Aspecia, Wildcard, Jamie Crespo, Liam Bearfield, Lunularity, Will Wisp, Timmy, Marshmallow Dream, Ashley Caswell, Yannick, Charlie Roman, Typo Queen Ray, Sachiko, Hecko Gecko Doodle, Trevor, Catherine Duvall, Brianna Vasquez, Katie Whitson, Creepy Creeps, Nathan O'Kane, Wilbo, Sev, Elise, Isile, Jasmine, Alex Beezer, Jose Ortega, and Banzail. Thank you so much for supporting at patreon.com/clue. Goodbye. So this is a confirmation email that Webkinz sent me to make sure I was actually me. I already used this pin and everything. I just wanted to point out that their subject line says important. This is a very important message from Webkinz. And another thing that I noticed is that this link at the top of the email, web.webkinz.com, if you click on that, it just goes to a 404 page. It's at the top of the email. Why is it 404?